truth is, in Topeka and Jefferson City, the Medicaid expansion arguments haven't changed that much in a year. The Missouri General Assembly and the Kansas Legislature remain conservative and a tough sell. Hospitals, doctors, and many business groups still argue that expanding Medicaid will not only make both states healthier, but will be an economic winner. But some things have changed. The political strategies, for one, and as of January 1st, real people are really affected.
I make too much to get Medicaid, but then I don't make enough to pay for the premiums, so I'm in the gap.
The gap. 29-year-old Sabrina Antofer is a working mother of two from Liberty who is on her way to a nursing degree. Until 2 years ago, she was covered by her husband's policy. But Robert got into an accident, went on disability, and eventually lost his health insurance. How we created the gap is a Byzantine legal and political story. Nobody planned it, but now states have to deal with it.
If you're extremely poor, you can get on Medicaid. If you're poor, you can get help from the exchanges or the subsidies. But if you're just really poor, you've got no help at all. And so there's a gaping hole in our safety net.
And that hole means Sabrina has to go to the free clinic here at the Clay County Health Department. But she can't afford cortisone treatments for a bad disc. She delays buying some medications and has no idea how she'll pay an $1,100 ER bill.
I think a lot of people think that there are all these people sitting at home, not working, just trying to live off the government, and they don't want people to get insurance, and they think that they're just trying to live, you know, off the government and get checks, and that's not what's happening.
So to help the 340,000 people in Kansas and Missouri who are in the gap with Sabrina, expansion proponents had to come up with a new approach.
So you tried last year to get Medicaid expanded, and that didn't work, right?
Right.
So what are you going to do this year that's different?
We're going to keep trying. I think what we're trying to do this year is to further a dialogue about what we might be able to do in our state that works for our state.
Tom Bell is president of the Kansas Hospital Association, and he thinks there's a compromise to be had at the Capitol.
I do not think that this Missouri legislature would pass a straight Medicaid expansion. They've been pretty clear about that.
And that's Andrea Ruth from the Missouri Medicaid Coalition. She too believes there's a deal to be made. But first, Kansas. The Hospital Association seems to be moving aggressively and creatively. Bell has hired former Utah Governor Mike Leavitt to try and craft a compromise. Leavitt was also George W. Bush's Health and Human Services Secretary. So he's credible on both the politics and the policy. Kansas has already transformed Medicaid into CanCare. So people are getting coverage from three private companies. And that privatization, Bell says, just may do the trick.
So yes, we would be doing it in the framework of our private CanCare program.
Well, don't you think that would be appealing to the current political climate in Kansas?
I think it's something that would work better in our state than maybe in some other states.
It may be harder in Missouri. As the session begins, GOP leaders seem just as hardened as a year ago. No expanding Medicaid without transforming it first, they say. Last year, the Missouri legislature said no after intense pressure from hospitals, chambers of commerce, and every major newspaper in the state. This year, Ruth says, the jolt for expansion just may come from religious and small, underfunded consumer groups.
You expect that some grassroots organizations are now going to tip the scale seems a little far-fetched.
See, it does, doesn't it? And I'm kind of idealistic about that, but let me tell you why I think that. Because that's what the legislators said. They're the ones who are gonna make that vote. And they're saying, we didn't hear from constituents in our district that they want this.
Ruth says her group, the Medicaid Coalition, is ready to talk about any transformations Republicans want to put on the table. And after seeing what's happening in some other states, she certainly can have some hope. Iowa just made a deal with the federal government for partial privatization, and reportedly Pennsylvania and Tennessee are also looking at similar deals. All three states are led by Republican governors.